Good evening. My name is TJ Glassmeyer, principal of Clermont Northeastern High School. On behalf of our Board of Education President Karen Crawford, Vice President Brian Sexton, board members Danny Ohart, Mike Mantle, and Julie Schmidt, our superintendent Michael Brandt, and our assistant principal Scott Haupt, it is my pleasure to welcome you to the commencement exercises for the class of 2020. The graduation ceremony is my favorite night of the school year. It is the culmination of years and years of hard work on the part of our seniors and their families. Just because we are not able to do it in person does not mean it is less special or less of an accomplishment. Our seniors have overcome so many things already, and I am confident they will conquer this obstacle and propel themselves to success in the future. I know they will take the lessons they learned over the past 13 years and use them to their advantage. The class of 2020 is full of students who are dreamers, who are caring, empathetic, enthusiastic, gritty, and those who are helpers, which we need now more than ever. I know they will take these qualities and leave a lasting impact on our community. The events of the past few months have made us look inward and have strengthened our families and our school community. I have seen the CNE community rally around our seniors to shower them with love, with praise, and to help them celebrate this milestone. I hope our seniors hold on to that sense of community no matter where the path of life takes them. We are incredibly fortunate to live, work, and learn in such a supportive community. Graduates of the class of 2020, tonight marks the end of a chapter in your life, but truly it is more like a beginning than an ending. The beginning of a new chapter that will take you to new heights and allow you to accomplish things you once thought were impossible. No matter where the path of life takes you, remember to keep working hard, persevering, and most importantly, keep reaching higher. There is no limit to what you can accomplish if you keep focused on your goals. Mr. Haupt and I have truly enjoyed watching you mature over the past 4 years into the confident, determined, and well-rounded young men and women that you are today. It has truly been a privilege for us to be a small part of your lives and to share this journey with you. Each and every one of you will always hold a special place in our hearts. On behalf of Mr. Haupt, myself, and the entire high school staff, congratulations. It is now my pleasure to introduce our guidance counselor, Mrs. Commissar.
Good evening. I have had the privilege of working with your seniors for 4 years as their school counselor. It has been my pleasure to watch the growth, dedication, and persistence, and especially flexibility of the class of 2020. Although this year ended in a way that none of us could have predicted, it cannot and will not take away from the accomplishments that we are celebrating here. Tonight, as we honor our graduates, I would like to share some of their accomplishments and also future plans with you. It is exciting to announce that the class of 2020 has received over $1.1 million in scholarships. Seniors at home, please stand if you have received a scholarship so that we can recognize you virtually. Our students worked very hard to challenge themselves, and this number comes as no surprise. This year, the senior class had 12 seniors enrolled in advanced placement classes such as English Literature and Composition and United States History. We also have 26 seniors who were enrolled in the College Credit Plus program through the University of Cincinnati Clermont College or Chatfield College. We had 31 seniors who are also graduates of the Great Oaks Institute of Technology or the Grant Career Center. And we've had 16 seniors who are receiving a diploma with honors for their commitment to academic success. While that is just a small snapshot of the paths that our students took to get here tonight, let's talk about the places our graduates will go. After tonight, approximately 50% of our graduates will further their educations by attending a 2 or 4 year college or a career trade program or apprenticeship. Approximately 45% of our graduates will enter directly into the workforce, and 4% of our graduates will serve our country by enlisting in the armed forces. At this time, I would like to invite those students who are choosing to enlist in the armed forces to stand at home so we can honor you. We are proud of all of our graduates and their accomplishments both inside and outside of the school day. I know that it was not without the love and support of you all prior to and especially during the pandemic situation that I'm hoping does not define the many years that you all have contributed so greatly to our district. At this time, I would like to have a round of applause for the parents, the families, and the friends celebrating with us here tonight. Thank you and congratulations again to the Clermont Northeastern Class of 2020. And at this time, it is my pleasure to announce Go the Distance by Alan Menken and David Zippel, performed by our select choir seniors.
I have often a far off place where heroes welcome would be waiting for me, where the crowds will cheer when they see my face, and a voice keeps saying, this is where I'm meant to be.
I'll be there someday. I will find my way. If I can be strong, I know every mile would be worth my while. When I go the distance, I'll be right where I belong.
Back, I can go the distance and I'll stay on track. No, I won't accept defeat. It's an uphill slope, but I won't lose hope till I go the distance and my journey is complete.
To look beyond the glory is the hardest part. For a hero's strength is measured by his heart. Ooh, 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 ooh.
Like a shooting star, I will go the distance. I will search the world. I will face its harms. I don't care how far. I can go the distance till I find my hero's welcome way.
Search the world, I will face its harms, till I find my hero's welcome waiting in your arms.
I would would now like to invite our superintendent, Mr. Michael Brandt, to share a few words of wisdom with our graduates.
Good evening. My name is Michael Brandt, superintendent of CNE Schools, and we are gathered here this evening to celebrate the graduation of our senior class of 2020. Congratulations, seniors. You made it to the final stretch, rounded the last corner, and you're about to become CNE's graduating class of 2020. Despite the COVID-19 madness that swirls around us, forcing us to close schools for an undetermined amount of time, I am proud that you will be given the opportunity tonight to become graduates of CNE as the class of 2020. I know, and your parents and families know, you are disappointed, upset, confused, and sad. This is not how the last 3 months of your senior year was supposed to go. You're missing out on not being able to enjoy the final months of your senior year, hanging out with your friends, dreaming about one last summer before you all head in different directions. You lost experiences like competing with your classmates on spring sports teams, the chance to attend your senior prom, the chance to cram with your friends for your final exams. And with all this being said, it is very natural that you may be feeling sad. This situation has certainly created a sense of loss. However, you are no strangers to adversity. 19 years ago, you entered the world at another tumultuous time when the war post 9/11 was forced to adjust and change your way of life as a result of the worst terrorist attack our country has ever experienced. You were our first students who have always had to go through security checks when you go to the Bengals Stadium or to Paul Brown or to the Reds. Or you've had to take off your shoes when going through airport security. You came into the world during a time of chaos, and chaos is now ushering you out of high school and pushing you into adulthood. You are used to uncertainty, and you know how to handle unpredictable times. Maya Angelou once said, "You may encounter many defeats, but you must not be defeated. In fact, it must be necessary to encounter the defeats so you can know who you are, what you can rise from, and how you can still come out of it." There is wisdom in her words. You see, life is not an endless sense series of pleasant experiences. We all learn from adversity. We learn about our character, our resolve, and we develop plans to move us forward. With what you have experienced over the years, and especially now, you are not rookies in the game of life. You are veterans with a lot of playing time left and plenty more time to learn and share with others. CNE promises that we will make sure that our graduates from high school are ready for career, college, and life. I personally believe you are ready, and everyone in the school district has done everything possible in our power to get you to the finish line. A century ago, the world was struggling to rebuild from the devastation of World War I and a World War pandemic. What they learned then is guiding our actions in response to the current pandemic of COVID-19. Guess what? How you react and act now will certainly guide our community in the future when the next crisis reveals itself. I am proud of your dedication and resolve. I admire your ability to face adversity and keep moving forward. While it may not be the senior year ending that you had dreamed of, it will be your senior year, unique among your peers, and you will reap the rewards. Stay flexible, stay patient, and be ready for your next challenge. Remember, you won't become members of CNE's graduating class of 2020 alone. You also become members of the greater community. CNE is your home, regardless of where you end up living, studying, or working. We have all enjoyed watching you learn and grow and look forward to seeing you succeed in all you choose to do. Good luck, and remember, you are always welcome here. Go Rockets.
At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce Kylie Hirth, the senior class president.
Hey guys, it's Kylie. I would like to start by saying thank you to the administrators for trying hard to reschedule and set up graduation for us. And to my classmates, I am honored to be your class president and deliver this speech on your behalf. Wow, we did it. We're graduating. It's crazy that we have known each other and been with each other for so long. I mean, it was just yesterday we were in elementary school, trading silly bands, playing on our Nintendo DS, and running around the playground. But then we moved to middle school, where we thought we were the coolest people when we whipped, dabbed, and nay-nayed. Now look at us. We are obsessed with Baby Yoda, Tiger King, and TikTok. We have a whole world of new fads just right there ahead of us. Who knows what the future has to hold? We are about to embark on the most important journey of our lives. These past 4 years have been so great with all of you. We put in so much of our time and dedications for just this exact moment. We did it. When we first walked through those high school doors, we had no clue what to expect. The lovely aroma every morning from the tar roof was so pleasing. But because of it, we got a pretty cool gym floor. And we also got Chromebooks. That made getting answers for homework so much easier. Thank you, Quizlet. One thing we can't deny is that we're definitely going to miss high school. This quarantine has just given us a glimpse of how much we're gonna miss it. I know I'm gonna miss those Friday night lights and cheering up in the stands. We're gonna miss those spirit weeks, dressing up for camo day, jersey day, and my personal favorite, pajama day. And how many other schools have a drive your tractor to school day? I'm gonna miss the pep rallies when we screamed our heads off to win the spirit stick, which we did multiple times. And I'm also gonna miss the hours we took to get ready for homecoming and prom. We're gonna miss the crowded hallways where we dodged book bags and freshmen. At this moment, I would like to apologize for the number of toes I may have stepped on walking down the hallways. But anyways, what we're really going to miss the most is the memories we made. Our high school memories are gonna last us a lifetime. As we have all felt, this quarantine has not been easy for any of us. We were trapped in our houses, unable to see our friends, and unable to finish off senior year the way we wanted it to. But we were given time to try new hobbies, like working out, cooking, drawing, learning TikTok dances, all while ruining our sleep schedules. Most importantly, we were able to look back upon the great times we've had in high school. High school provided a way for everyone to find a place they belonged. There were those who found academics their priority, and we had so many students on honor roll. You guys put so many hardworking hours into achieving that. We then had those involved in clubs. You all really made our school stand out with your dedication and your hardworking service. Next were the band and choir kids, the most supportive people in the school, constantly cheering on your classmates. It's crazy to think that people used to come to our football games just to watch the band. But thank you, football team, for finally stepping up your game. Now let's talk about those amazing athletes. Because of you all, we won the SBAAC National Division All Sports Award for the very first time. You guys put your blood, sweat, and tears into each game, match, race, to not only represent yourself, but the great school that you attended. We all found our calling in high school. We grew out of our cringy middle school selves, and we began to grow, and we're still growing. We are on our way to success. We have all worked so hard for this diploma, and here it is. We did it. I want to take a moment to say a special thank you to our teachers and staff. Thank you for always being so helpful and supportive to us during our time in and out of high school. You taught us very valuable things, like the story of Romeo and Juliet, the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell, and let's not forget Pythagorean theorem. But anyways, you guys really helped us grow and prepare for our adulthood. Class of 2020, We did it. We've gone through our own tests and trials, but in the end, we made it. No more state tests, no more summer reading, no more 10-10 rule. This virus was just one of the harder trials that we have faced, but we have overcome it and become stronger. Most importantly, it was together. This virus had shown us that we're never alone. To the administrators, staff, parents, and the rest of the community, thank you for your never-ending support. To my classmates, here's a little advice. Don't be afraid to make mistakes, and don't be afraid to fail. It's what makes us human. We learn so much from our mistakes, and they help us grow. Go into life with an open mindset. Try new things. YOLO. Color outside the lines. Be who you want to be and do what you want to do. But most importantly, don't let anything stop you from following your dreams. I am so proud to be a 2020 graduate of Clermont Northeastern, and I'm so grateful to have you all by my side. Congratulations, class of 2020.
At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce Lane Young, our Great Oaks student representative.
Good evening, everybody. I'd like to start out by congratulating my fellow class members on making it this far. I never imagined that I was going to be the one standing in front of you giving a graduation speech, and I really never imagined it was going to be online. My name is Lane Young, and I was one of the few students that decided to attend Live Oaks. Like the rest of my classmates who made that decision, I wanted a head start, a skill that I knew would prepare me and give me a plan for after graduation. From an early age, I'd always loved cars. I'd loved working on them and learning as much as I could about them. In fact, if it hadn't been for a 1956 Chevrolet Bel Air with a highlighter yellow engine block, I might not be where I am today. With that being said, I figured it was an obvious choice for me to take auto mechanics. I knew walking into Live Oaks for the first time that I'd had a bright future ahead of me. But what I didn't know is that the teachers in that school have a burning passion to help you succeed. The 2 years I spent at Live Oaks were the most productive and developmental years of my life. Leaving there now, I don't just have an education in a trade, but I have a large set of skills that have helped me become a more professional and employable person, and someone who is better prepared for adult life. If I hadn't made that decision to go to Live Oaks, I wouldn't have the opportunity to be where I'm at now. I'm walking out of high school with certifications and work experience, something that it would have taken years and a lot of money if I had decided to wait. Live Oaks isn't just another school, but it's a chance for students to get ahead of the curve and learn how the working world really operates. And that's a lesson that you don't get very often.
At this time, I would like to introduce Lauren Gilstrap, the Class of 2020 Academic Leader.
Hello, everyone, and what an honor it is to be able to deliver this speech. To begin, I would like to congratulate my fellow graduates on their achievements and the hard work and dedication it took to accomplish this milestone. While graduating online may not have been our expectations growing up, we can still persevere and make this a memorable occasion. The best way I know how to feel connected with my fellow classmates over the screens you will be watching this on is by reminiscing on our times together over the course of our careers. First, our freshman year. When they tell you high school goes by fast, they really mean it. It almost seems like yesterday that we were walking through the halls and went through orientation for the first time. We did not know the path we were going on, so we insisted on following in the footsteps of the classes before us. You could spot one of us a mile away. New hairdos, all new school supplies and outfits. I guess we thought that would make us fit in. By our sophomore year, we finally felt like high schoolers. We got comfortable cheering at games and dancing at homecoming. Some of us had learned to drive and even had loud, dangling keychains to show for it. Before we knew it, it was our junior year, and we had to really crack down. Suddenly, we were upperclassmen, taking on leadership roles and trying harder than ever. This was the year of CCP and AP classes and balancing reports, projects, and assignments all at once. We took the ACT and we survived until our last year. Our senior year has been indescribable, to say the least. We tried to make the most of our last year, and for the few months, we did. 4 years ago, we entered high school with aspirations, and today is about us taking the next step to even bigger ambitions. As we celebrate the challenges we have overcome and the personal growth we have all achieved, I would like to reflect on a few lessons I have learned over the course of my high school career. First, do not be afraid to be yourself. This seems cliche, and it probably is, but it was something I was always told and still overlooked. As we all grow and find our place in the world, do not be afraid to adapt with the world around you. As said by John F. Kennedy, change is the law of life, and those who only look to the past or present are certain to miss the future. Secondly, look at every day and every small goal as a step forward. For us today, graduation is a huge leap forward. Take this milestone to pave a successful path for your future. We all will have different lives, achievements, and obstacles along the way. Let's continue to encourage one another to reach our dreams and take on that goal, no matter what it is or how long it takes to get there. High school was about finding yourself, but now we must move on and pursue our passions that stemmed over the course of this journey. As we go our separate ways, I would like to leave you with this. It's not about how far you go, but how far you've come. Look at every uncertainty as another opportunity. I will close my speech by saying thank you to every one of my classmates for your influence on me and making my high school experience a great one. Thank you to my teachers for helping me discover my passions, coaches for motivating and pushing me, and my family for the love and support along the way. These times may be tough, and quarantine even tougher, but the sacrifices were worth the exchange. Just look at how we have strengthened within our community and how hard parents and educators are trying to give us a special senior year. Always remember that we are the class who made history, the class of 2020. Thank you.
It is my pleasure to introduce Fireball by Pitbull, arranged by Tom Wallace, as performed by the concert band directed by Chris Moore.
1, 2, 3, 4.
As I mentioned earlier, the community has truly rallied around our seniors to shower them with love, with praise, and with hope. From the group on Facebook, who in a matter of hours adopted every single one of our seniors and gave each one gift baskets, to Crossroads Eastside, who generously offered to put this ceremony together for us, and to our local congressman, Representative Brad Wenstrup, who, when he heard of our plans to hold an online graduation ceremony, offered to share a special message to our graduates. Thank you to the CNE community, Crossroads Eastside, and to Congressman Wenstrup for supporting our seniors. Please enjoy this message from United States Representative Wenstrup.
Hello, Mr. Glassmeyer, Superintendent Brandt, Mr. Pennington, faculty, families, alumni, students, and especially the class of 2020 at Clermont Northeastern High School. Thank you for the honor and unique opportunity to be part of your graduation ceremony again this year. Graduates, yours is a great accomplishment, another step forward as you carve out your chapter in history. And so much lies ahead. Abraham Lincoln once said, "I will study and get ready, and perhaps my chance will come." And that's what we're all called to do. And here you are now, In a changing and challenging world, your world is about to change yet again. As you drive forward towards accomplishing the American dream of putting a roof over your head, meals on the table, provide for yourself and your family. You know, life itself is work. As you experience life, you can turn your experiences into the service of others. Again, study and get ready. Some of you are going to college, others into the trades, some right out into the workforce, others are joining the military. There's really no wrong answer except doing nothing. So wherever you go from here, know that your work has a purpose. To me, every job is essential, because no matter the work, you're providing something that someone wants and something someone needs. I like to tell this story about the lowest ranking sailor on an aircraft carrier who's out swabbing the deck, just cleaning the deck, and someone comes up to him and says, "Sailor, what do you do?" The sailor looked him right in the eye and he said, "I make sure that planes land safely. What about you?" So it's all perspective. You know, as a surgeon, there's a lot I can do in the operating room, but I can't build it. And I can't fix the equipment. We all need each other. And you may change professions along the way. I can tell you that when I graduated from high school, I knew I wanted to be a doctor. I didn't know that I would join the military later. I didn't know that I would run for Congress. You know, often young people will come up to me and say, "Congressman, I'd like to be in Congress someday. What should I do?" And I look them right in the eye and I say, "Something else first." I think that's what our founders had in mind, to build upon our experiences in order to serve others. We all have a journey, an earthly mission. Your journey through life is not completely about you. It's about those that you journey with, your family and your friends. They'll guide you along your journey. The company you keep will steer your journey. Choose wisely. It matters. Today you close only one chapter in the book about your life. And those around you, classmates, teachers, family, have all had a part. Your education here is just the beginning of your adventure. However, this high school experience is the foundation to the rest of your story. How have you built that foundation? Do you have a code that will guide you? I want to tell you about Mike Spann. Mike Spann was a Marine and later joined the CIA. He was the first American killed in Afghanistan after the attacks of 9/11. On his CIA application, he said, "I believe in the meaning of honor and integrity. I'm an action person who feels partially responsible for making changes in this world, because if I don't, no one else will." In the Army, we have a list of virtues. Spell out the acronym LEADERSHIP: loyalty, duty, respect, selfless service, honor, integrity, and personal courage. As decent human beings, you will all need a set of standards, a code of ethics. There's no substitute for ethics, and you can't truly succeed without them. The stain of bad ethical decisions and bad ethical actions will rarely, if ever, go away. And really, more often than not, good decisions and ethical behavior may not even be recognized. But do it anyway. What will you consider to be success? Where will money be on your list? Often the most rewarding things that we do for no pay. These are true acts of service, where we do something for someone else without the thought of reward or payment. The true measure of your wealth is actually what you invest in one another. Earning a good living is far from being wrong, because often that is what allows us to do more for others. Will you lead? How will you lead? Will you recognize, as Emerson once said, that everyone you meet is in some way your superior, and from them you can learn? Will you have the bravery of Todd Beamer, who on 9/11 said goodbye to his wife, went off to work, was on a plane over Pennsylvania, and when he realized that that plane was going to be used to kill so many Americans, he and others on that plane said, "Let's roll," and they took that plane down? Will you have the strength and courage of Chesley Sullenberger, calmly landing his plane on the Hudson River, making sure that all were off safely before he exited? Now, not everyone's going to have tests like these, but you will be tasked with something, and you'll be tested often. Sometimes the task we face may scare or intimidate us, but do it anyway. You'll have many challenges. one thing can never be taken from you: the ability to look in the mirror at the end of the day and know that you've done your best, done things right, and that you've been fair to others. Mother Teresa is credited for a prayer or poem entitled Anyway. And in that, it reminds us that what you spend years building, someone could destroy overnight. The good you do today, people will often forget tomorrow. And when you give the world the best you have, for some it may never be enough. Do it anyway. True reward and success usually comes at the end of a struggle, hard work, and often after some failures as well. Whatever others may expect of you, expect even more of yourself. Be the person that others trust, the person that others can count on, the person that others willingly turn to in times of need. Have faith in yourself as I have faith in you. Be proud of your accomplishments, as all of us in this community are so very proud of you. Life is about your journey that lies ahead, the lives that you touch, the message that you send, the example that you set, and how you would change the world for the better. It's a tall task. We're all counting on you. I know you're up to it. Congratulations. Good luck. Stay well, and may God bless you.
Clermont Northeastern High School is proud to present the graduating class of 2020 and the conferring of diplomas. I would like to invite the senior class advisor, Mr. Tony Gutler, to please come forward to announce each member of the class of 2020.
Asia Marie Adkins. Allison Paige Algiers. Trent Logan Amon. Maxwell Harrison Anstad. Carly Ray Apgar. Austin Case Askren. Abigail Lenore Averwater. Madison Audrey Bacon. Abigail Michelle Baker. Kathleen Elizabeth Beck. Natalie Sue Bachman. Isaac Russell Bosley. Damian McCain Bowen. Kylie Gracie Ann Bragg. Jeffrey Lewis Brockman II. Dakota Henry Brown. Kennedy Shannon Brown. Jared Paul Burns. David Wayne Chafin. John Logan Clark Richards. Victoriana Sue Clevenger. Charles Keith Cole. Dalton Allen Collins. Bridget Marie Comberger. Tyler Lee Robert Conley. Albert Martin Corey. Ian Bryce Crawford. Seneca Rosie Crawford. Jesse Lynn Carruthers. Valerie Paige Curran. Calvin Joseph Dalby. Jake Andrew Dane. Brandon Allen Davis. Jared Thomas Decatur. Michaela Eileen Drury. Daniel Lee Eichenlaub. Nicholas Allen Ferguson. Carson Grace Fishback. Sarah Grace Francis. Donald Wayne France Jr. Lauren Ray Gilstrap. Nicholas Ryan Goodine. Savannah Grenzer. Shane Michael Haggard. Cecilia Barbara Jane Harvey. Jonathan Wayne Hatfield. Dakota Austin Hawk. Tyler Jacob Hempelman. Madison Riley Henke. Andrew James Hill. Kylie Elizabeth Hirth. Robert Michael Hogan Jr. Joseph Wayne Hudson. Nicholas Benjamin Huff. Ashley Laureen Jones. Jacob Wade Jones. Cole Anthony Joslin. Michael Riley Kelch. Charles Anthony Kent. Blake Michael King. Courtney Denise King. Joshua Stephen Kippenberg. Mariah Raylin Krieg. Jonathan Foster Kuntz. Wyatt James Ledbetter. Brittany Leanne Leonard. Daniel Joseph Lichtenberg. Mackenzie Marie Leitner. Elizabeth Grace Jane Lindsley. Tyler Joseph Lloyd Davis. Justin Robert Luce. Audrey McKenna Meager. Ronald Joshua Meyer Jr. Morgan Renee Miller. Gracie Lynn Minton. Kaylee Elizabeth Moore. Melanie Joy Morehouse. Noah James Morehouse. Muhammad Kaber Muhammad. Cameron Alexander Nabich. Trenton Wayne William Nichols. Connor Ian Noel. Sari Palafox Becerra. Gage Robert Pettit. Gavin Lee Matthew Poe. Austin Trey Hodorf. Mackenzie Faith Reese. Hannah Nicole Rosen. Haley Elise Savoy. Carly Ann Schwarber. Jesse Ann Siri. Destiny Michelle Xiang Sang. James Terry Shepherd. Nicholas Short. Taylor Lynn Schumard. Olivia Pumahani Mayalani Sloan. Joshua Allen Smith. Madison Nicole Sparks. Richard Joseph Springer IV. Joseph Michael Stevens. Lindsay Renee Stevenson. Madeline Storm Stevenson. Molly Ann Stetson. Samantha Marie Michelle Stewart. Jacob Matthew Stone. Hannah Jade Teary. Tierra Spring Thunberg. Travis Dwayne Thunberg Jr. Sarah Ruth Twine. Patsy Grace Valenti. Robert Dewan Washington. Jill Ann Wellage. Bethany Aaron Nicole Wells. Patrick Keith Wethington. Alyssa Dawn Williams. Clayton Charles Williams. Destiny Mercedes Wilson. Noah James Ray Witt. Kathleen Elizabeth Workman. Lane Lloyd Young.
Thank you. During the summer of 2018, the class of 2020 tragically lost one of their own, Micah Matthews. At this time, Micah's family has prepared a short video that we will share in her honor.
Micah, we are always reminded of you when we spot a pink balloon, a piece of paper you wrote on to remind us of something, or when we simply feel your presence near us, ready to help, just as you always were. You are still there, and the laughter we hear, because yours was so contagious that it still carries on. When the water catches the sun just right, we see the twinkle of your eyes. We want to share our joys with you. Do you still hear them anyway? In these moments, we let the pain in our heart sting while we catch our breath and remember that this is you keeping the promise you made to come see us again. You know you'll miss me, you said. You'll come see me, I replied, and you do. We love you now and always.
Members of the Board of Education, Superintendent Brandt, the members of the CNE Schools Class of 2020 have completed all the coursework required by the State of Ohio and the Clermont Northeastern Schools Local School Board. It is my great pleasure to declare them high school graduates and confer upon them all the rights and privileges that it entails. Congratulations to the members of the CNE Schools Class of 2020. I would now like to invite Lauren Gilstrap, Kylie Hirth, and Lane Young to come forward and lead the class of 2020 in the tassel turn. I would invite our seniors at home to stand and turn their tassels at the same time. One, two, three. Thank you all for joining us tonight to celebrate the class of 2020. They are an amazing group of young men and women, and we could not be prouder of them. Also, thank you to Crossroads Eastside for organizing, recording, and editing our virtual ceremony. We truly appreciate their willingness to help and their dedication to our students. Thank you, and have a great night.
hero's welcome would be waiting for me, where the crowds will cheer when they see my face, and a voice keeps saying, this is where I'm meant to be.
I'll be there someday. I can go the distance. I will find my way. If I can be strong, I know every mile would be worth my while. When I go the distance, I'll be right where I belong.
Down an unknown road to embrace my fate, though that road may wander, it will lead me to you, and a thousand years would be worth the wait. It might take a lifetime, but somehow I'll see it through.
And I won't look back. I can go the distance, and I'll stay on track. No, I won't accept defeat. It's an uphill slope, but I won't lose hope till I go the distance and my journey is complete.
But to look beyond the glory is the hardest part, for a hero's strength is measured by his heart. Ooh, 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 ooh.
Like a shooting star, I will go the distance. I will search the world. I will face its harms. I don't care how far. I can go the distance till I find my hero's welcome waiting in your arms.
I will search the world, I will face its harms, till I find my hero's welcome.